Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are delighted that you're here. We want to welcome you to Allen Arena. We also want to welcome you to the commencement of the 132nd session at Lipscomb University. Today is a very special day, as you well know, and that's exactly why you're here. And we have a lot of very important things to deal with over the next few moments. And so let's begin our commencement ceremony. Led by Ford Quinn, who's the Associate Dean of Engineering, and he's carrying the university flag, entering the arena with him are candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Professional Studies. Bachelor of Science. Bachelor of Science in Nursing. And Bachelor of Social Work. And now, entering the arena, led by Angel Bebout, registrar, are faculty representatives for the College of Bible and Ministry, the College of Business, the College of Education, the Raymond B. Jones College of Engineering, the George Shinn College of Entertainment and the Arts, the College of Leadership and Public Service, the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, the College of Pharmacy and Health Sciences, Lipscomb Online, and Beeman Library. Entering the arena, led by Kent Klinger, professor of chemistry, and carrying the school mace, Kent Klinger, the professor of chemistry, is carrying the school mace, and he is followed by Provost Jennifer Shoemaker, the executive leadership team, the senior leadership team, the academic leadership team, representatives of the Board of Trustees, and stage guests. Thank you. And now, entering the arena, the 18th president of Lipscomb University, Dr. Candace McQueen. Now, would everyone please rise and join me in congratulating the class of May 2023. You may be seated. Thank you, and you may be seated. Please welcome with me the Provost of Lipscomb University, Jennifer Shoemaker.
Here now, in the presence of candidates for academic recognition, members of the faculty and administration, alumni, trustees, honored guests, and friends of Lipscomb University, the 132nd commencement is now convened. Commencement is an important landmark in the life of a student. Today, our faculty and students entered the arena led by a mace. A mace is a ceremonial symbol of authority, but this mace is special. It is made from a tree that fell on David Lipscomb's farm and is a beautiful representation of what we at Lipscomb believe. Just like this broken limb has been transformed and given authority over this ceremony, you too are transformed through Christ and have been equipped through your education that you have received here. As we move forward in today's commencement, you will see that it's filled with symbols that represent the historical significance of this ceremony and the deep importance of education. For example, the colors that line the hoods of your graduate level faculty members represent the university that conferred the degree. The trimmings of the gowns represent the discipline that the individual studied. If you want to learn more about the gowns and the symbols and the meanings of the colors, please look on page 44 of the program. The order of today's program is listed on page 17. It is now my pleasure to introduce Mike Fernandez, Dave Morgan, and Hope Nordstrom. Mike Fernandez is the Dean of the George Shinn College of Entertainment and the Arts. He's been at Lipscomb since 2008. And his son, Brendan, is graduating today. Mike is going to lead us in the invocation. Dave Morgan is Assistant Professor of Psychology and Marriage and Family Therapy. He's been at Lipscomb since 2001, and his daughter, Emma, is graduating today. Dave will be reading our scripture, Ephesians 3, 14 through 21. Hope Nordstrom is Associate Provost of Education and special counsel to the president for strategy. She and her husband, Steve, associate professor of computer science, have a son, Jared, who is graduating today. Hope has been at Lipscomb since 2012 and will be giving the faculty charge. Mike will now come and lead us in our invocation.
Good afternoon. Before I pray, let me just say congratulations to all of you students. But I got to give a special shout out to all the CEA students that are graduating today. Congrats, You did it. I'm so proud of you. And then, give them a hand. And, of course, Brendan, I remember the first day I took you to preschool, and now here we are. Let's go. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you now and invite you into this momentous occasion. Dear Lord, let us feel your presence in this place as we celebrate these graduates, their family and friends, as well as the faculty, staff, and administration of this university. Father, today we pray a prayer of thanksgiving, of celebration, and of supplication. Lord, first we offer a prayer of thanksgiving for the support offered these graduates by their family and friends. We are so thankful for fathers, mothers, grandmothers, grandfathers, aunts, and uncles who made so many sacrifices for them to attend this place. We are also thankful for brothers, sisters, cousins who provided emotional support and encouragement to continue even when times got tough and they thought they couldn't do it. We are thankful for the friendships that were developed over these years at Lipscomb. Friendships forged through countless sleepless nights working on projects, sharpened by shared transformational experiences like mission trips and service projects, enriched by memories of Singarama, social clubs, and countless student life events. We pray that these friendships will continue on well beyond their time at Lipscomb. We are thankful for all these relationships, as we know these graduates would not be here today without them. Lord, we also offer a prayer of celebration for an educational process they have completed. We honor and celebrate the faculty and staff who not only pass on knowledge through teaching, but also share wisdom through mentoring, and who finally build the bond of love through authentic relationship. Lord, we offer a prayer of thanksgiving for Lipscomb University. We are thankful to be a part of a place whose mission is to train each generation to go out into all aspects of the world and serve others while glorifying you. We are thankful for a place where we can openly proclaim your good news. We pray that you continue to give favor to this place so that your light can continue to shine through these halls and future hearts for many generations to come. Lord, today we offer a special prayer of supplication for these graduates. We pray on their behalf that you would convert the knowledge they have gained in their heads to a wisdom that will fill their hearts. We pray that you would help them see their career not as a platform to elevate themselves, but rather one to serve you and lift others up. Help them in their lives to remember the greatest command, to love you with all their heart. Help them to truly love themselves and to know that they are enough, not because of how they look or what they achieve, but because they are yours and because they are made in your image. Help them through the ups and downs of life to develop a peace that passes all understanding, and for that peace to live firmly in their hearts so that they may be able to love their neighbor as themselves. And finally, may they be blessed with long lives. May they and their families learn to be strong in the faith, and may their legacy not be measured by the wealth they have amassed, but by the relationship they have grown with you. These things we pray in the name of the one you sent, the one whose life, death, and resurrection give us hope, your one and only Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'm doubly honored to read over you today. As a faculty member, I'm proud of so many of you. And as a father, I'm proud of one of you in particular. When they asked me what scripture I wanted to share, I could think of no better blessing than Paul's prayer for the Ephesians. Ephesians 3, 14 through 21. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be the glory, and in the church, and in Christ Jesus, throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
Class of 2023, on behalf of the faculty, let me be one of the first to congratulate you on your amazing accomplishment. I'm truly honored and humbled to be able to share a few words with you today. On Monday, August 19th, 2019, most of you sat in your very first classes as freshmen. It seems like it was just yesterday. Life was good that first semester. You were acclimating to college life, studying hard, right? And making new lifelong friends. Who would have known that just a few months later, during your second semester of college, that the world would be experiencing a global pandemic, that campus would be shutting down, and you would be leaving campus at spring break and not returning that semester. You all took a chance and persevered. That you would return the next fall to classes, masked and often cohorted, where you were attending in person 1 week, and also 6 feet away from one another, and then joining the class via Zoom the next week. I know there were many times that you had no idea what was going on from week to week. Rest assured, your faculty were right there with you. You all took a chance and persevered. As we have watched campus be renewed over the last 2 years with amazing accomplishments both inside and outside of the classroom, I want to say thank you for your resilience. You have made a positive impact on this campus, and we are truly blessed for you sharing your lives with us over this time. In one of my favorite children's books by Kobe Yamada, the child in the story asks the question, what do you do with a chance? There are some amazing chances that come around, and the child doesn't know what to do with them, as he's afraid of risking too much to explore them. This story paints a beautiful picture for all of us, as we all have lots of chances that come into our own lives. So, what do you do with a chance, especially one that seems too big or just out of reach? Should you hold back, ignore it, let it slip away, or embrace it? My faculty charge for you includes three key things to consider as those chances emerge. First, make sure those chances align with your purpose. I encourage you to understand what you were created to do and begin doing it. Ephesians 1:11 from the Message translation states, "It's in Christ that we find out who we are and what we're living for." Long before we first heard of Christ and got our hopes up, he had his eye on us, had designs on us for glorious living, part of the overall purpose he's working out in everything and everyone. This verse shows us that it is in Christ we find out who we are, our identity, and then what we are living for, our purpose. Even one of my favorite people of all time, Dolly Parton, she said, "Find out who you are and do it on purpose." I mean, if Dolly said it. As you discover more deeply who you are and explore those chances that come your way, your purpose will clearly show why you are here in the world and what roles you are being invited to play in partnering with God. You might ask, how will I pull this off? What you may fail to realize is that everything you need has already been gifted to you. You are not the first to think this. There are so many examples throughout the Bible, including Moses at the burning bush. In Exodus 4:1-2, Moses answered, "What if they do not believe me or listen to me and say, the Lord did not appear to you. Then the Lord said to him, what is that in your hand? Or David taking on Goliath in 1 Samuel 17:40. Then he took his staff in his hand, chose five smooth stones from the stream, put them in the pouch of his shepherd's bag, and with his sling in his hand, approached the Philistine. Both Moses and David started with what was literally in their hand, a staff, which also included their stories, their experiences, their strengths, and their failures. Just like Moses and David, when those chances come, lean into the gifts, talents, and strengths that God has already given you. In Brené Brown's book, The Gifts of Imperfection, she talks about cultivating meaningful work as a guidepost for wholehearted living. Brown's research shared the following connections. We all have gifts and talents. When we cultivate those gifts and share them with the world, we create a sense of meaning and purpose in our lives. Squandering our gifts brings distress to our lives. When we don't use our talents to cultivate meaningful work, we struggle. We feel disconnected and weighed down by feelings of emptiness, frustration, resentment, shame, disappointment, fear, and even grief. Sharing our gifts and talents with the world is the most powerful source of connection with God. Third, when those chances come your way, be open to how God calls you. It may be something really out there, like Moses' experience with the burning bush. However, it could also be through a whisper, like God spoke to Elijah. Proverbs 16:9 reminds us, we can make our plans, but the Lord determines our steps. Show God your availability to him. Be open to those opportunities, as they may take a totally different form than you ever imagined. Not only be open to how God calls you, but also be open to ask questions. Have a sense of wonder. Use those critical thinking skills your instructors have all been talking about. Be open to learning, unlearning, and relearning. Lean into knowing you may not have all the answers and how someone else's perspective may be really helpful. So my encouragement to you today, as those chances come your way, make sure they align with your purpose, lean into your gifts, talents, and strengths, and be open to what comes your way. And as the child in the story shares with us all, maybe I don't have to be brave all the time. Maybe I just need to be brave a little while at the right time. I realized it was up to me. So, what do you do with a chance? Just as you have done during your time here, you take it, because it might be the start of something incredible. Congratulations to each of you on this graduation day. We are so proud of you.
I would like to call your attention to some awards listed on page 34 of the program. I'm going to ask some different award winners to stand up, and we will applaud for all of them at the end. So, for our outstanding teachers for this year, please stand as I call your names. The outstanding teachers for the year are Kirsten Dodson, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Hunter Stanfield, Assistant Professor of Family Science, and Josh Strahan, Professor of Bible. The David Lane Travel Allowance was awarded to John Smith, Professor of Chemistry. John, will you please stand? And the John William Baker Award was awarded to Flora Mishlanga, Professor of Biology. Flora, will you stand? Let's recognize these faculty members. Now, Prentice Ashford, Dean of Community Life, will come to recognize our Marsh Award recipient.
The Stephen Lee Marsh Christian Example Award is given in honor of the late Stephen Lee Marsh. Steve was a 1977 Lipscomb graduate and the son of one of our former board members, Lee Marsh. Although Steve's time on earth was short, his impact for good was great. He was a Christian example in every aspect of his life, as a student, as a businessman, in his service to the church, in his love to his family, and in his generous support of good works. This award is presented to the senior student who plans to pursue a secular vocation and whose Christ-like spirit and behavior, while a student at Lipscomb, has demonstrated a propensity to continue throughout life to be a light in the world, a servant to humanity, a worker in the church, devoted to family, and a herald of their faith in Christ. This year's recipient is Jessica Geddes, a family science major from Chattanooga, Tennessee. She is the daughter of Julie and Bobby Geddes. Jesse, please stand.
We will now begin the awarding of diplomas. We will be conferring diplomas by degree categories, and we ask that you hold your applause until all have received their degrees in each category. I also want to let you know that we are streaming graduation on the internet for people who couldn't be here, so please make sure that each graduate's name is allowed to be heard and celebrated. Will the candidates for the degrees Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Fine Arts, and Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Professional Studies, please stand. President McQueen, I am happy to present these candidates for the degrees Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Music, and Bachelor of Professional Studies for the May class of 2023. They have completed the course of their studies specified in the catalog and have successfully passed their examinations. On behalf of the faculty, I am happy to recommend them as being worthy to receive their respective degrees. The candidates for graduation in August are within one semester of completing their work, and we're also happy to recognize them at this time and present them with the binders for their diploma.
By the authority of the Board of Trustees and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon you your respective degrees with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Anna Michelle Adams, summa cum laude. Ashley Allison, magna cum laude. Bradley T. Anderson. Peyton Anderson. Christine Twee Andrew, magna cum laude. Brooke Elizabeth Baker, summa cum laude. Zane Arnett, cum laude. Dustin Baker. Jordan Taylor Balton, summa cum laude. Ethan James Barham, summa cum laude. Ty Benham, Parker Ellis Bonner, cum laude. Kinley Abigail Boyd, summa cum laude. Alyssa Brand, magna cum laude. Sarah Mae Bratcher, summa cum laude. Gray Breen, cum laude. Annabelle Lindsay Bridges, Alexander Robert Brown, Phoebe Bruno, cum laude, Natalie Butler, summa cum laude, Kelly Elizabeth Cates, Keilani Milan Cave, summa cum laude. Alyssa Veronica Tracova Holland, summa cum laude. Alexandra Teresa Clancy, summa cum laude. Caitlin Elizabeth Clausen. Colton Levi Cogswell, summa cum laude. Meredith Lee Comstock. Lily Kate Corley, summa cum laude. Juliana Angelia Corral, cum laude. Lily Kathleen Cottrell. Susan Rose Crawford. Charles Samuel Dabbs, summa cum laude. Jeldrick Dahlman, summa cum laude. Victoria Elaine Davis. Francesca Decker, summa cum laude. Patricia Ann DeMore, magna cum laude. Noah Bradley Dixon, cum laude. Tian Ehrenreich, summa cum laude. Joseph Sherman Ellington. Ivan Enriquez. Cameron S. Ferry, cum laude. Cassidy Lee Fessmeyer, summa cum laude. Catherine Flora. Jordan Elise Forbes, magna cum laude. Michael Austin Gable, cum laude. Tanner Germany, summa cum laude. Chandler Giles. Cameron Marie Given, summa cum laude. Daniela Elizabeth Rivera Gonzalez. Tyler Rose Grant, cum laude. Greta Ruth Haas, summa cum laude. Sean Patrick Hagen, cum laude. Chuen Hu, magna cum laude. Lydia Jernigan, summa cum laude. Elliot Grace Jones, magna cum laude. Zoe Guest. Hamilton Jones. Jacqueline Renee Keith, summa cum laude. Lauren Walden Kells, magna cum laude. Jamesia Kimbra. Robert Knight, magna cum laude. Sarah Knott, summa cum laude. Olivia Grace Lauer, summa cum laude. Samuel Patrick Liggett, magna cum laude. Callista K. Lincoln, summa cum laude. Shauna Carmen Mann, cum laude. Benjamin Eli Massa, magna cum laude. Eliza Mudd McLaughlin, summa cum laude. Sheldon Lane McMurtry, summa cum laude. Riley Jordan Mingus, summa cum laude. Kara Kathleen Michelson. Elena Ramsey Miller, summa cum laude. Sarah Grace Miller, magna cum laude. Jordan Taylor Minix, magna cum laude. Yeah. Austin Mitchell, magna cum laude. Micah Morris, summa cum laude. Cameron Lee Napier, magna cum laude. Mary Margaret Nestor, cum laude. Gina Marie Norrid, summa cum laude. Linda Obergon, summa cum laude. Sarah Jane Overly, cum laude. Elizabeth Lane Peck, magna cum laude. Madeline Grace Parrish, summa cum laude. Demetrius O'Neill Parson. Blythe Isabel Pearson, magna cum laude. Dulce Maria Perez Garcia, magna cum laude. McCaslin James Podlesny, summa cum laude. Christian Velasquez Ramirez. Rachel Morgan Randolph, summa cum laude. Grace Ann Richardson, summa cum laude. Graham Collins Roach, summa cum laude. Meredith Gray Roberson, magna cum laude. Savannah Hope Roberts, magna cum laude. Omar Esteban Gonzalez Rodriguez, cum laude. Isabella Romero, magna cum laude. Ariel Reuter, summa cum laude. Kim Sitor. Hannah Nicole Sever. Emma Catherine Shanahan. Addie Elizabeth Sigmund, summa cum laude. Michaela Hannah Selinsky, summa cum laude. Luke Snyder, summa cum laude. Aaliyah Loren Sorrentino, summa cum laude. Cole Steven Spencer. Madeline Louise Stevenson, summa cum laude. Sydney Joe Stevens, summa cum laude. Naomi R. Stokes, summa cum laude. Danelle Stolfus, summa cum laude. Noah Richard Stump. Abigail Thompson, summa cum laude. William Clark Turner, summa cum laude. Elizabeth M. Ward, summa cum laude. Victoria Wheeler, summa cum laude. Amanda Hope Williams, summa cum laude. Catherine Elizabeth Williams. Allison Yelitz, magna cum laude. Emma A. Zakardonic, summa cum laude. Bachelor of Business Administration. Austin Ladd Aleph. Andrew Amin, cum laude. Peter James Becker, cum laude. Maxim Bogdanovich, magna cum laude. Matthew John Bonert, cum laude. Margaret Jennifer Bradford, cum laude. Peyton Avery Brandenburg, magna cum laude. Annabelle Lindsay Bridges, summa cum laude. Davis Wade Brock. Adele Massey Brothers, summa cum laude. Killian Byrne. Isabella Gray Cantwell, magna cum laude. Julia Carvalho Cohea, magna cum laude. Casey Summer Collier, summa cum laude. Ava Jessera Comer. Anna Cooper. Kendall Elise Crawford, magna cum laude. Matthew Seth Cruz. Jarrett James Kraus, cum laude. Amira Crow, cum laude. Sage Eliza Danner. Andrew Michael Dragon, cum laude. Copeland Thomas Esslinger. Edison Dale Eubanks. Robert Bruce Evans Jr., cum laude. Brendan Fernandez. Daniel Everett Ford. Zach Franzoni. Paola Sitlali Lopez Garcia, magna cum laude. Benjamin E. Govan. Alexander Jackson Green, summa cum laude. Owen M. Green, cum laude. Samuel Lee Hagen. Robert Allen Hamilton. Micah Hawkins, magna cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Heffington, summa cum laude. Reed Christopher Hicks. Cindy Hong, cum laude. Sydney Lauren Hopkins, magna cum laude. Perry Ann Howard, summa cum laude. Lauren Rachel Hummerkhaus. Morgan Sean Hurley, cum laude. Taylor Kong Kubricki. Anna Claire Latta, summa cum laude. Bashoy Lewis. Alejandro Lopez, cum laude. Jeffrey Martin, magna cum laude. Jordan Robert Marwood. Gregor McKenzie, summa cum laude. Fady E. Megley, summa cum laude. Aiden Gearhart Miller. Zane Mills. Philip Mina, cum laude. Jason Eugene Montgomery, magna cum laude. Alexander Corley Moore, cum laude. Jared Steven Nordstrom. Jack Elliott Palmer. Alexandria Grace Pardue, summa cum laude. Samuel Adam Parrish. Mallory Ann Pedigo, summa cum laude. Bethany Mitchell Pullman, summa cum laude. Audrey Sophia Reyes, magna cum laude. Catherine Grace Rickman, summa cum laude. Sailor Roach. Juliana Patricia Rojas, cum laude. Trevor Cole Roseman. Samantha Rubio. Brennan Thomas Sarver, cum laude. Estrella Shear, cum laude. John Shanuta. Nathaniel A. Sizemore, cum laude. Mary Catherine Smith. Tate Braden Smith, cum laude. Jason R. Southall, magna cum laude. Matthew Stewart, cum laude. Anessa Marie Sweeney, magna cum laude. Anya Trebesnik, cum laude. Britton G. Waller. Brooke Elizabeth Watts, cum laude. Michaela Noelle Weber, summa cum laude. Alexis Williams. Amy Wu. Ashton Young. Bachelor of Fine Arts. Chloe Elizabeth Arvin, summa cum laude. Zephaniah Bean. Sophie Grace Bussell, magna cum laude. Avery Diane Butts, summa cum laude. Hannah Noelle Clark. Caden Ikari. Ashton Kate Ellis. Victoria Elizabeth Griffin, summa cum laude. Sarah Faith Harrison, cum laude. Julia Hill, magna cum laude. Colin Hodgkin, summa cum laude. Jared Carter Jennings. Natalie Paige Kaser, summa cum laude. Grace Kwok, magna cum laude. Ellie Lenz, summa cum laude. Aurora Lillestrand, summa cum laude. William Hayden Luckett, magna cum laude. Kaylin Elise McGuire, summa cum laude. Mason Camp Martin. Michaela McGarrell, cum laude. Stephen Mitchell, summa cum laude. Emma Grace Morgan, magna cum laude. Destiny Mosby, magna cum laude. Jacoby Murray. Hal Myers. Zachariah Aaron Olson, magna cum laude. Matthew Christopher Pless. Julian Nicole Rice, magna cum laude. Jonathan Fletcher Thomas, summa cum laude. Megan Elise Urbitas, magna cum laude. Audrey Jane Venable, summa cum laude. Charles Robert Webb, summa cum laude. Tyler Warden. Bachelor of Music, Justin Alcorn, magna cum laude. Alex Fincher, summa cum laude. Kate Gill, summa cum laude. Noah Gregory Hagard, magna cum laude. Camry Alexis Hoffman, magna cum laude. Michelle Lane McCleary, summa cum laude. Nina Christine Petro. Journey Thuin, cum laude. Sophia Dawn Winter, summa cum laude. Anthony William Zamora, magna cum laude. Bachelor of Professional Studies. Danielle Ann O'Quinn, summa cum laude. Sarah Bailey. Rachel Lauren Kristoff. Matthew Fitch. Kristen D. Kennedy. Lielan Lane, cum laude. William Thomas Ross Wagoner. You may be seated.
Congratulations. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and Bachelor of Social Work degrees, please stand. President McQueen, I am happy to present these candidates for the degrees Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and Bachelor of Social Work for the May class of 2023. They have completed the course of study specified in the catalog and have successfully passed their examinations. On behalf of the faculty, I am happy to recommend them as being worthy to receive their respective degrees. The candidates for graduation in August are within one semester of completing their work, and we're happy to recognize them at this time and present them with the binders for their diplomas.
By the authority of the Board of Trustees, and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon you your respective degrees with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Bachelor of Science, Shiloa Mary Allison, magna cum laude. Fatima Abbas Alamusali, Plutarchus Alanonefti, Leo Alvarado, Esther Eunice Alvarado Luna, magna cum laude. Santos Alvarez Garza. Sarah Ashley Antonio, cum laude. Brevin Chase Apple. Meredith Archer, cum laude. Cassidy Faith Ashby. Sam Adele Atala, magna cum laude. Benjamin Azael Aviles. Miriam Azer, summa cum laude. Malik Baker. Mary Barsoom, magna cum laude. Alan Bass. Diari Goran Bikhtiar. Caitlin Marie Ben Dixon, summa cum laude. Maggie Taylor Bevins, magna cum laude. Nardos Baruch. Thomas Bitzer, cum laude. Madeline Grace Bowles, summa cum laude. Hunter Scott Bozeman, summa cum laude. Evan Corinne Bowen, summa cum laude. Brooke Bauer, summa cum laude. Brett Boyd, magna cum laude. Darian Chevis Boyd. Isaac Brayton. Elijah Cade Brooks, summa cum laude. Alexandria Ann Brown. Lee Caroline Breyer. Grace Elizabeth Booker, summa cum laude. Catherine Rose Ballard. Sydney Lee Caldwell, magna cum laude. Peyton Elizabeth Carpenter, cum laude. Alana Carroll, summa cum laude. Darcy Taylor Colvert. Amelia Elizabeth Cook, cum laude. Alyssa Corso, summa cum laude. Leah Corso, summa cum laude. Alexandria Cox. Shelby Lynn Kraft, magna cum laude. Courtney Cummins, magna cum laude. Elisa DeVar, summa cum laude. Gracie Anna DeSuarte, magna cum laude. Olivia DiApollo, magna cum laude. David Downs. Savannah Dawn Dugan, summa cum laude. Taylor McKenzie Duncan, cum laude. Tim Earl, summa cum laude. Hunter B. Emanis, cum laude. Mariel Indral, summa cum laude. Madeline Riley Enos, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Osaye Aromosela. Abby Fink. Caitlin Robinson Fisher, cum laude. Aaron Fortner, summa cum laude. Stephen Fulton. Nathan Lee Gatos, magna cum laude. Haley Ann Gaines. William Geasley, cum laude. Jessica Rose Geddes, summa cum laude. Camden Gilbert, cum laude. Lacey Nicole Gilmore, magna cum laude. Millie Grace Genevico, summa cum laude. Chase Alexander Goodwin, cum laude. Leroy Sivanen Gorcharin, cum laude. Elizabeth Blair Gold, magna cum laude. Molly Grant, cum laude. Gabriella B. Groves. Anna Catherine Guptison. Gracie Hall, magna cum laude. Kinsey Elizabeth Hamlet, summa cum laude. Joshua M. Hanslip. Huda Halter, summa cum laude. Miranda Helikunihi. Amanda Ray Higginbotham, summa cum laude. Celia Summerhill, summa cum laude. Jalen Sky Holcomb, cum laude. Andrew Hooper, cum laude. Trapton S. Hauk. Taylor Hudson, summa cum laude. Jacqueline Muniz Huerta, summa cum laude. Shanaz Mariam Hussany. Benjamin Gray Eisenberg, cum laude. Brady Connor Johnson. Logan Alexander Jones. Austin Wilson Justman, cum laude. Kaylee Keller. Rochelle America Kelly, cum laude. Jeffrey Kendig, magna cum laude. Corbin King. Caitlin J. Kirby. Zachary Knight. Abigail Cohn. Ashlyn Kimberly Korpak, cum laude. Danielle Ladinez. Melissa Lane. Eden Latham, summa cum laude. Haley Catherine Lewis, summa cum laude. Rachel Renee Living, summa cum laude. Ryman David Lawler, summa cum laude. Molly Longmire, cum laude. Esther Jatanjali Lucas. Joseph Malham. Jose Antonio Mata, magna cum laude. Peyton Trent Mattingly, cum laude. Kaylee Grace Medikevich, magna cum laude. Taylor Alea Smock, magna cum laude. Sydney Lynn McClary, magna cum laude. Keegan David McClure. Logan Noel McFadden. Elizabeth Grace McKeel. Bailey McMillan. Mackenzie Meadows, summa cum laude. Angie Medina. Leslie Crystal Mendez. Kennedy Lee Miller, cum laude. Sierra Madison Moody, magna cum laude. Rayleigh Elizabeth Moore, cum laude. Margaret J. Mosby, summa cum laude. Raymond Edmund Narleski III. Holly Rochelle Neal, magna cum laude. Ryan Patrick Nelson. David Peter Nguyen, magna cum laude. Louis Wenya. Hannah Elizabeth Noakes, magna cum laude. Olufemi Odunusi. William Jacob Ogle. Michael Robert Osborne. Trajan Hilton Johnson Parks, magna cum laude. Kimberly Pate, magna cum laude. Kellyanne Paulson, cum laude. Michael Perry. Emily Lauren Phillips, magna cum laude. Ryan Jeffrey Pope. Benjamin Allen Powell. Grayson Pullias, magna cum laude. Joshua Daniel Purnell. Mac Reeder. Benjamin Powell Reichard, magna cum laude. Lindsay Kate Reynolds, summa cum laude. Megan Louise Rice, cum laude. Paige Reitman, summa cum laude. Jack Roland Roper. Lana Sincari. Elizabeth Ann Sass. Kanal Sandeep Sawat. Lorelei Self Cum Laude. Graydon Schaefer. Isabel Elise Sharaya. McKenna Lynn Shepherd. Elizabeth Marie Shoemaker, magna cum laude. Michael Sibley. Olivia Ann Sibley, cum laude. Ellen Catherine Smith, summa cum laude. Jaquiel Smith. Jonathan Edward Smith. Madge Suki. Joseph Spillers, cum laude. Elizabeth Standifer. Angela Louise Steidel. Claire Morgan Stevens, magna cum laude. John Cameron Stevens. Luka Stojanovic, magna cum laude. Christiana Tatum. Zion Apprentice Thomas, cum laude. Emily Grace Tidwell, summa cum laude. Katie Trevathan, magna cum laude. Chloe Trin, cum laude. Audrey Aji Salwagwe Safak. Kevin Tumulva, summa cum laude. Maylee Shea Turner. Amara Emmanuel Ukazim. Tessa Maureen Vanderkamp, summa cum laude. Joshua Vilmeet, summa cum laude. Robert Noah Walker, cum laude. Taylor Sky Warnock. Austin Tyler Webb, summa cum laude. William Douglas Welch, summa cum laude. Matthias White. Allison Williams, cum laude. Kyle Nathan Williams, cum laude. Ashley Nicole Witucki. Caitlin Ann Woodside. Madison Grace Woodson, summa cum laude. Kaylee Grace Wu, summa cum laude. Emily Ann Jakubowski, magna cum laude. Darwin Zuniga Flores. Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Megan Riley Baines, cum laude. Taylor Elizabeth Boyd, magna cum laude. Alondra Jasmine Brazil. Chaley Elizabeth Brown, cum laude. Marley Josephine Boltice, cum laude. Kelly DuTemple, cum laude. Brooke Edwards. Jennifer Finnegan. Christine Jane Graham, cum laude. Haley Renee Hall, cum laude. Jaden Marie Hansen. Brianna Hill, magna cum laude. Laura Elizabeth Jenkins. Mackenzie Marie Johnson, summa cum laude. Emily Rebecca Jones, cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Klein, cum laude. Kelsey Grace Lahung, cum laude. Chloe Maya Leung. Selena Danlin Liu, summa cum laude. Matthew David Mitchell, summa cum laude. Chidinma Praise Okorie, cum laude. Jose C. Padron. Lucia Sienna Johnson Parks, magna cum laude. Hadley Bell Pate. Sarah Marie Simmons, magna cum laude. Tyler Austin Smelser, cum laude. Joshua Alexander Smith. Reese MacArthur Smith. Scotty Nicole Smith, magna cum laude. Jenna Steele, magna cum laude. Abby Rose Tarter. Victoria Tesmer. Melody Joy Villanueva, cum laude. Brenna Grace Ware, cum laude. Molly Lauren Zobrist, summa cum laude. Bachelor of Social Work, Kennedy Elizabeth Bradshaw, summa cum laude. Jessica Fincher, summa cum laude. Kayla Marie Gibson, summa cum laude. Mary Janice Hill, summa cum laude. Shelby Nicole Hobbs, summa cum laude. Micaiah Evie Hoff, summa cum laude. Alexis Loriel Ketterman, magna cum laude. Alicia Louise Lewis Deaton, summa cum laude. Jalisa Rocio Correa Martinez, summa cum laude. Ashley K. Mugglevane, summa cum laude. Please be seated.
Graduates, we are so proud of you. I want you to take a moment in the midst of this busy day to just take a breath and be proud of the hard work that you've done and know that God has great plans for you to use this education to be light in the world. And we're so thankful for you and proud of you. I want to introduce you all to our president. In 2021, our Board of Trustees selected Dr. Candace McQueen to lead Lipscomb University as its 18th president. She was no stranger to Lipscomb, having been a senior vice president, dean of the College of Education, founding director of the Ayers Institute for Teacher Learning Innovation, a professor, a teacher at Lipscomb Academy, a parent of two Lipscomb students, and a Lipscomb student herself. She is known statewide across the country for her leadership and education. Before becoming president, she led one of the nation's largest education nonprofits, serving 22 states in improving the effectiveness of teachers. And from 2015 to 2019, she served as Tennessee's top education official as the education commissioner appointed by Governor Bill Haslam. She is known for her drive for excellence, optimism, and get-it-done strategic planning, and the theme that she selected for her inauguration was Be a Light. She has encouraged all of us, faculty, staff, and students, to be a light, and she has led by her example. In her time at Lipscomb, I know that each one of you has had the opportunity to be touched by her care for you, for her excellence, and also in her admonition to you all to be a light. She's shown her devotion to our students in so many ways, and I know you have felt that. In all that she does, President McQueen's dedication to Lipscomb and to you is evident. I am so thankful for her great care, for the way she leads with excellence and intentionality. Please welcome to the podium President Candace McQueen.
Congratulations. You are officially the May class of 2023. Let's give them a big hand. I want to take a moment to recognize all of the people in this arena who have helped make this a reality. So if you're a parent of one of our graduates, would you please stand and remain standing? If you're one of our parents,
If you're a spouse or a child of one of our graduates, would you please stand? We have a few of those in the room. If you're a grandparent or a great-grandparent of one of our graduates, would you please stand? And then folks at the back, if you taught one of our graduates, would you please stand? And if you just need a quick stretch break, go ahead and stand up too. All right, let's give all these folks a big hand for what they've contributed to our education. Every member of the May class of 2023 has a unique journey that has led them to this moment. But I want to share just a few of these stories with you. Earning a college degree is something Alexis Ketterman has dreamed of doing from a very, very young age. A first-generation college student, Alexis received her Bachelor of Science degree in social work with minors in social science and law, justice, and society. She says earning her degree means that she is now capable, as a first-generation college student, to do whatever she sets out to do. From a young age, she had a deep desire to help others and wants to be the very best social worker for her clients. Next, she's going to pursue her Master of Social Work degree at the University of Tennessee at Knoxville, and she's interning with the Legal Aid Society. And then there's Aiden Miller, who's in our audience today. He graduated with a degree in finance. While a student, Aiden has been making an impact on the world around him. As a freshman in the College of Business, Aiden launched Quizera Coffee, where the purchase of bags of coffee and booking a mobile espresso bar directly contributes to programs in Rwanda. Over the last 2 years, Aiden has developed his coffee farm project to now have over 5,000 coffee trees. Today, the property will serve as the first stepping stone for research on improving coffee yields for farmers in Rwanda, as well as a new model of vertical integration and transparency for the industry that brings more prosperity to farming communities. Following graduation, Aiden plans to pursue a career in real estate investing in addition to continuing to grow Quizera Coffee. He says he plans to dedicate his life to the transformation of the continent of Africa, and he's doing this in two ways. First, he'll create hope through economic empowerment, and he will create the ultimate hope and truth that Jesus Christ has to offer the world as he serves there. Today, we're also celebrating Maddie Bowles. She's completing a double major in environmental science and philosophy. For her senior capstone project, she explored the process of community formation in mixed-use environments like the Gulch in downtown Nashville. She is currently working as an intern in community and regional planning at the Greater Nashville Regional Council, where she plans on continuing her work and serve through the end of the summer. And today, Summer Hill walked across the stage to receive her degree in mechanical engineering and applied mathematics. Her love for artistic design and mathematics inspired her to pursue a double major. Through her studies, Summer has been inspired to use her skills to solve problems and to serve others. She's participated in multiple projects in Honduras, one creating a solar project for a school, a solar project for a clinic, and the design and construction of a medical waste incinerator for a hospital through her senior design project. Summer will attend Clemson University to pursue a master's in mechanical engineering this fall. And finally, Osama Al-Salman is celebrating the completion of his technology management degree. He has had a unique journey to this milestone. Originally from Baghdad, Iraq, Osama began his college studies more than a decade ago, but dropped out after his first year to begin as a combat translator for the United States Army. Osama eventually found his way to Nashville and began working in the technology sector. While here, he
he attended Nashville State Community College for 2 years. And then in 2019, he moved to Geneva, Switzerland, to take on a role as an information and evidence officer for the United Nations, creating technology systems that manage international criminal investigations. Despite his extensive experience and job, Osama always had a goal of completing his bachelor's degree. He was familiar with Lipscomb because his wife is an alum. She has a Bachelor of Science in Chemistry and a Master of Management here from Lipscomb. So in the spring of 2021, Osama enrolled at Lipscomb in the online program. And for the last 2 years, while he's worked for the UN, he's been taking classes online from Lipscomb all the way from Geneva, Switzerland. And this afternoon, he's watching live from Switzerland. Let's give these graduates a big hand and the stories of so many in this room. In an excerpt from a poem entitled Miriam by John Greenleaf Whittier, we read, "We search the world for truth. We call the good, the pure, the beautiful from graven stone and written scroll, from all old flower fields of the soul. And weary seekers of what's best, we come back laden from our quest to find that what all the sages said is actually in the book our mothers read." With Mother's Day just a week away, and don't forget it, and because we have so many mothers in the audience, my brief charge today comes from practical life lessons from my mother. My mother grew up as the middle child of three on a farm in Stewart County, Tennessee. She's from a town called Big Rock. It was small enough to have no stoplights. Her parents sacrificed for her and her siblings to attend Lipscomb as first-generation college students. She often shared with me growing up that Lipscomb shaped her with a foundation that centered her and helped her grow big dreams, but also taught her how to live the daily walk with God. In her career, she went on to be an award-winning school principal, leading two of her schools to national blue ribbon status and eventually winning the National Distinguished School Principal Award in the 90s. She went to Washington, D.C. 3 times in her life to get these awards. I'll never forget her acceptance speech when she won the National Distinguished Principal Award. Her talk was different than anyone else's I heard that night. Her entire speech was not about her. She talked about the people that she wanted to recount on her journey that had helped her learn and be shaped. Her glory was fully given to others, and it was given to God for the path that he had put her on. In the words of Greenleaf Whittier, in the book my mother read, she worked to make her first choice be for God, and her book was always the Lord's book. On that foundation, she provided me, as you can imagine, with lots of wisdom, lots of pearls of wisdom. In fact, pearls of wisdom that were in the rural Big Rock language where she grew up. And I believe 3 are very appropriate for today. They are her words, and they're in her language, but they scream of God's truth. So lesson 1 from my mother. Hatch your own eggs. Now, she grew up on a farm. Hatch your own eggs. I was not sure when I first actually heard that, but I had to have been about 5 years old. She would frequently reference some story about a person, and it would appear in a conversation. Maybe it was about a friend who was struggling at work. Maybe it was about someone who had left their job decision-making in the hands of other people. She often would tell stories about why did folks not take initiative and stand up for what they needed to do. My mother would share this story, and then she would always turn to me. It never failed, and it was always to me. And she would say, "Remember, you need to hatch your own eggs." So what in the world does that mean? Well, graduates, let me apologize because this advice might sound like it's time to kick you out of the nest. But I will say it's a little more than that, although that's embedded. You've had a lot of help to get you here today. But it's time for you now to fully step up and step out. This doesn't mean that you will still not get help from others, but your mindset should be on set. It should be set on hatching your own eggs. Just like no one can go out and exercise for you, or no one can do the job interview for you, no one can take your place in line at graduation today, and no one can live your daily life. No one can hatch the eggs that you were meant to hatch. Meaning, you need to be proactive. You need to look up, and you need to look inward and decide decisively the next steps you should take. Ask the questions you need to ask. Don't wait for someone else to say, "Aren't these the questions you should ask?" Do the planning it takes to explore options for what's next. Don't wait for someone else to come to you and say, "This is what's next." My mother also made sure I knew that people, spouses, friends, parents, colleagues, they will contribute to your happiness, but they can't make you happy, and they can't produce the joy that only comes from above. This is the choice that you must make for yourself. And it only comes from that personal relationship with God. So hatch your own eggs. Lesson two from my mother is even more potentially rural in its nature. You can't win a vomiting contest with a buzzard. Let me say that again. Lesson two, you can't win a vomiting contest with a buzzard. This is definitely a big rock saying, but it is universally true. All the inherent challenges that come with life on this earth will come to you in future years. And I can guarantee you that you will have job experiences, peer relationships, personal interactions, and even social media moments that will not be helpful to you. They won't be helpful to you mentally, emotionally, or spiritually. And this will come in the form of people who are truly buzzards. And I want to go ahead and call this out for you, as my mother did for me, because it is quite freeing. Let's think about it. What do buzzards do? They eat roadkill, and they eat as much and as aggressively as they possibly can until they vomit out most of what they've eaten. Think about it. If you get caught in a contest of words or a battle of wills with a buzzard, you will never win, as they love to be aggressive and they will always out-vomit you. Buzzards, you know. In fact, I have a feeling the people sitting around you know buzzards. They're self-absorbed. They're always right. They don't listen. They play politics to its worst possible end. They're social climbers, and they quite frankly feel better when you feel worse. You will encounter them if you haven't already, sometimes in subtle ways and sometimes in more dramatic ways, but they're there. And I encourage you, as my mother did, not to avoid them, as you actually can't avoid them, but to recognize them and to run from these encounters. And when they do happen, you need to get away as quickly as you can. These encounters produce stress, anxiety, anger, vengeance, and hatred, the opposite of what we want in our life. Scripture affirms this in the Gospels when he tells the apostles, when folks aren't listening to them, "Shake the dust from your feet and go to the next town." I'd say this to you: when these happen to you, don't linger. Don't try to figure it out. You need to move, and you need to move quickly to anything that is hindering you from the work ahead of you. Because remember, you cannot win a vomiting contest with a buzzer. And the last lesson from my mother, probably not correct from an English perspective. She would say to me, "Think good to do good." My mother's life was lived in aggressively protecting her thoughts. Before there were podcasts and Christian music stations on the radio, she used to listen to tapes, cassette tapes. Y'all remember those things? And they were tapes about positive thinking. She listened in the car. She listened when she was getting ready for work. She listened when she was cooking. She listened anytime she had space to learn. And looking back, I remember she was doing that when she needed to refocus. Remember, think good, to do good. Scripture affirms this in Philippians 4:8. Whatsoever is true, whatsoever is noble, whatsoever is right, whatsoever is pure, whatsoever is lovely, and whatever is of good report, think on these things. This is the beginning of good action. Think good, and you'll do good. My mother spent the last years of her life battling Parkinson's, but she was still giving me pearls of wisdom and nuggets even to the last day. One thing she quoted to me often, as her body could not do what she wanted it to for others, she would say, "Remember, when you do for others, you actually end up doing more for you." And then she would say, "A man or a woman wrapped up in himself or herself makes a very small package." So simple, but so true. Never underestimate the power of serving others and getting out of ourself to lessen our own challenges and struggles. And it also ends up enlarging hope and opportunity for others. So here are the lessons. Hatch your own eggs. You cannot win a vomiting contest with the buzzard. And think good to do good. These pearls of wisdom remind me of words from Proverbs. "My son, keep your father's commandments and never forsake your mother's teaching." I hope these words from my mother will be remembered as you take the next step on this remarkable journey that you have in front of you. It is a journey, quite frankly, that many bison before you have taken. And it's a journey that will bring you adventure, fulfillment, service, meaning, joy, hope, and love. Take advantage of every moment you have. And remember, your Lipscomb family is always in your corner, and we will always be your herd. We love you, and congratulations.
Now, Sanctuary will lead us in singing the Alma Mater. After the Alma Mater, the benediction will be led by Dick Cowart, Chair of our Board of Trustees, and we will then have the tolling of the bell. It is a tradition at Lipscomb to toll the bell once for each decade the school has been in existence. This is our 132nd year, so today we will toll the bell 13 times. The words to the Alma Mater are on the inside back cover of the program. Everyone, please stand and join in singing the Alma Mater led by Sanctuary. After singing, you may be seated for the benediction, the tolling of the bell, and the recessional.
Lipscomb, hail to thee. Hear our heartfelt prayer. Truth and servanthood guide us all our days. Precious scenes of days gone by, give us strength today. Robed in beauty, led by faith, show for all to see. Loving God and humankind, Lipscomb, hail to thee. Lipscomb, hail to thee. Hear thy children's song. Grateful hearts now,
Trinity. God protect and give thee peace, lives come hail to thee.
Mic's on. My mic is now on. Thank you. We're a bit ahead of schedule, so before we close with a prayer, there are two people I'd like to recognize who don't know it. First, there's an individual in the room who served 23 years on our Board of Trustees. He served 6 years as vice chairman and the last 6 years as chairman. By my count, he has signed and handed out close to 10,000 diplomas by the authority of the trustees that you hear. And so, David Solomon, thank you very much for what you've given to this institution. We are indebted to you. And second, seated behind me is an institution within the institution. Countless times there are problems that arise in the university or in the community, and they just quietly go away because someone who knows how to untie knots that frequently involve, people and issues comes to the rescue. His name is Walt Lever. This past spring, we had one of the most terrific events that's ever occurred in our city with the shootings at the Covenant Schools that broke the hearts of not just the nation, but the world. They needed a place to heal. Walt Lever, without any recognition, without a range for them to move to the Brentwood Hills Church of Christ, where they are now being loved and where he has been ministered. He has been minister for many years. Walt, our university, our city, and our nation are indebted to you for who you stand for and what you do. Thank you, Walt. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to pour blessings on the faculty and staff. They have for the past 4 years given of themselves to these graduates. They have taught them with knowledge. They have taught them with care. They have helped them in times of trial. They have encouraged them, and they have made them ready to leave and to be leaders unto themselves. Please continue to bless the faculty and staff. Dear Heavenly Father, to these parents, thank you for the commitment they made many years ago to not only be parents, but most importantly, to raise children that are committed to Christian values, to take the sacrifices that are necessary to be good parents and to pay for a Christian education. Please thank those parents and ask the graduates to do so as well. And finally, dear Heavenly Father, we ask a really measure of your blessing on these graduates. They are ready to be salt and light to the world. And as this thundering herd of new bisons leave, let them be a joyful noise throughout the land. In your Son's name we pray.
This has truly been a wonderful afternoon for many, many reasons. And I feel like there's one more thing that we may want to do one more time before we dismiss in here. and really continue the celebration outside on this beautiful, beautiful afternoon. But as you know, right in front of me are nearly 500 graduates, brand new graduates, who have tremendous accomplishments in so many different directions, not just academically, but also just in the way you live your lives. And then behind them are several rows of faculty members who represent an army of men and women who give their lives here on this campus and other places around the world, teaching students as a part of the faculty of Lipscomb University, and they have worked hard to help these graduates get to where they are today. And I just feel like while they remain seated, there are other people here in this audience who want to really give it all you've got with one more standing ovation of appreciation and congratulations. What about that? Now we'll ask everyone to take a seat, and the celebration will continue outside and then probably all over the city with different plans that people have made. But what we want to do is we're going to ask the faculty and staff and graduates and those who are participants on the stage, we want that group to stand while everybody else remains seated. If you will stand, and Kent Klinger is going to take the mace, and he will lead the group out along with the bagpipes, and they will go out, and we'll give you one announcement after they recess and are outside of the Allen Arena. We have one more announcement for the audience.